high school, I struggled. I struggled for a lot of reasons. Class time for me, it was difficult because I had difficulty sitting still. I was what you would call a pretty hyper child. So as I matured, I realized that, you know, I had to take it serious, and I had to study, and I had to pay special attention to things, because studying, it didn't come easy to me. I had to work at it. You know, when I was in high school, if we saw a kid with his nose in a book, or, you know, studying more than everyone else, we probably would call him nerdy or something like that. But what I realize now is that those same individuals are now running companies. They're now in charge of governments. I mean, they're doing really well. So what I would change is I would spend more time in the classroom, focus on getting great grades and preparing for my future. Because those same individuals that, you know, I may have made fun of because they had their nose in the book all the time, they're now our bosses. School is the foundation for your future earnings, your future jobs. And so we ask kids all the time, you know, what do you want to do with your life? And kids in high school. Because oftentimes they look at you like, oh, I'm a teenager, why would you ask me that now? And the truth is now is the time you have to decide. You know, do you want to end up in jail? Do you want to end up dead on the street somewhere? Or do you want to end up having a nice house with a nice family, a nice car? And when you usually say things like that to kids, oh, I want a great car. You know, I want a beautiful wife, 2.5 children, things like that. We point that out to them now, because it's important that you have to plan for your future. After being in law enforcement for 20 years, I've seen where families have been torn apart because of things like substance abuse, alcohol abuse, domestic violence. And that all kind of goes hand in hand with individuals who don't have the education or the experience to understand how to deal with real life issues. So staying in school, getting good grades, all that will prepare you for a brighter future. I've seen kids who've dropped out. I've seen kids who were little, who I unfortunately had to arrest for a variety of crimes. And now, 20 years later, I'm seeing their kids' kids who are doing the same thing or getting into trouble for doing it, for committing crimes. It's a learned behavior. So if you can stay in school and stay away from that criminal element, you'll do well in life. So your choices are real simple. You go to school, you get good grades. You know, college might not be for everyone, but for employers, people who are looking to employ young people, they want college now. So you can go to school and excel and do the hard work now so it'll be easier later in life. Or you can take what you may think is the easy road, quit school. But that path will take you to nowhere. That path will take you to jail. That path will take you to maybe losing your life on the street somewhere.